Have you heard those sounds? The grills are sizzling, fryolators are bubbling. The summer eating season is getting into full swing. Ted Reinstein decided to celebrate with a Shnurble on the road, and then Shana found some IPA and pinball.
Tangy St. Louis ribs, tender Ipswich clams, sweet Maine lobster. Summer has a taste all its own. Tonight, we embrace this all-too-short season of gastronomic bliss.
Here you go, my brother. Look at that beautiful thing.
Just off Route 128 at Exit 40 in Wakefield sits a roadside stand that is heaven for hot dog and sausage fans. Using two green eggs, the gold standard of charcoal grills, Fred's Franks pumps out six varieties of Italian sausages and three sizes of Pearl Brand hot dogs, including a monster half-pounder.
Speedy Dog in Boston, he's not there any longer, but he used to sell the pound hot dogs Pearl makes. I can't sell somebody a pound hot dog. I just don't think it's right. I don't want to kill him.
A character and a half all by himself, Carl Galasso is the second owner of Fred's Franks. After being laid off from a high-tech job, he bought this stand in 2010 after seeing a Chronicle story, no less, about opportunities in the food truck business. Since that time, he's turned Fred's Franks into a must-stop for ravenous carnivores.
You know, we always used to have company, and I was always the griller. I love to serve. I love to cater to people. I want to make them feel loved. But I just love cooking for people. I love making them happy. When somebody comes to you and they say, you know, you made my day, or I was having a bad day and I had to come here and get a Shnurble.
Say what? A Shnurble is a mountain of sausage, franks, spicy slaw, and secret sauce so flavorful it's positively habit-forming.
It's nice, it's sweet and heat.
Yeah, and then the combination with the meat, the chorizo and the hot dog, combination with the sweet cabbage, the mayo and the sriracha baba, it's just, welcome to the addiction.
There you go. That's what I said. I said you are enabling addicts everywhere. You're even trumpeting it on your t-shirt.
It takes time to make a Shnurble, not to mention eat one, but thankfully Frank's is a schmooze fest for the foot-long crowd in waiting, but oh my, is it worth the investment of time and cholesterol?
So this is the Shnurble.
This is the Shnurble, these are chorizo.
So this is chorizo?
Yeah.
Yeah? So you got two nice little pieces of chorizo sausage.
I give you three.
Oh,
this
three.
This is a super Shnurble.
And
this is the half a monster dog, yeah.
Oh my God.
And we try to get it in so they hug each other,
God.
And you can close it, you know? There you go, my brother. Look at that. Welcome to the baptism of the Shnurble.
Hallelujah. That's all I can say as I ponder how to attack this monster in my grasp.
Little piece of heaven, I hope.
You know, I was really past all my addictions.
And now look what you did to me.
A new brewery is nothing new. They're popping up all over. But a brewery with vintage pinball machines, now you're talking.
You're just showing off, you know.
I think you're the one showing off.
Most fun a dollar can buy.
Did we win?
Donovan Bailey started brewing his down-the-road beer 2+ years ago. Now he's banking on both beer and pinballs to pack them in at this new 12,000-square-foot brewery and taproom in Everett.
I think we're the only brewery that owns our own pinball. And one of our goals is to get the top 10 pinball machines. I've always enjoyed playing with mechanical things. I always say the Rube Goldberg machines at work, like all the flashing lights. It's a blast. The air pressure is
building. Bailey's buddy John keeps the machines humming.
They're pretty robust machines. I mean, think about a computer working from 1989 that was in a bar room half its life, a smoky bar room at that.
Bailey is also fascinated with folklore and fairy tales. Check out the names, not to mention the artwork on the beer cans.
We kind of pride ourselves on the art. This gal, Nikki Rosignol, out of Missoula, Montana. I found her searching for a Pukwudgie image.
Pukwudgie?
Pukwudgie is actually a mythical creature from Wampanoag legend. Supposedly they live in Freetown Forest. They're like 3 feet tall, little mischievous creatures that lure you into the woods.
Pukwudgie and other curious creatures will flow from these 36 taps, accompanied by pop-up dinners and food trucks.
It's a little bit of work in progress, yeah.
For the taproom, maybe, but not the beer.
We got a nice review from Beer Advocate. Right now, it seems like anything hoppy people love. So, you know, we've been trying to feed that itch for folks.
Beer and pinballs just down the road.
And laid off in his mid-50s, Carl Galasso of Fred's Franks, as you heard, saw a Chronicle program about the boom in the food truck business. So he took a chance, cashed in his 401k. He now says he wishes he had done it earlier because he's been so happy grilling for people. Carl says he didn't invent the Shnurble. Fred, the previous owner, did, but he's mastered marketing it to a cult status. But when it comes to clams, they are very picky.
It really has to be shucked that day or the day before.